When I say cryptocurrency, you say transparency, which is very useful when it comes to investment analysis. Welcome to the latest film from Currency.com, where I'm going to tell you all about the world of on-chain analysis, an essential part of helping you make better decisions when it comes to crypto. Before we get going, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. It helps me know that I'm doing a good or bad job. You ready? Okay, let's crack on. Thanks to the transparent nature of blockchain, cryptocurrency's transaction data is available for anybody to see in a way unheard of in the pre-crypto financial systems. This provides an opportunity to dissect investor behavior like never before. And this is on-chain analysis. A couple of things to note. While this gives us incredible insights, it's not a magic bullet. It's hugely valuable in telling a story of what happened with other metrics. But like all investment analysis, it won't always deliver huge profits or guarantee against losses. It is continually evolving. And as more users come into Bitcoin and adoption grows, the network behavior changes. So what has been before may not play out in the same way in future. Okay, that's the risk warning out the way. We are going to use the king of crypto, Bitcoin, to show you how it works. But you can get insight on any publicly available blockchain. There are a number of metrics, and these include transaction count, transaction volume, and active addresses. But we're going to look at new entities. So looking at the new entities chart, what we see is as the price of Bitcoin rises, so does the number of new entities in the network. Conversely, when we see a drop in the Bitcoin price, we see the number of new entities reduce. And this is in line with the hype and mania in bull runs, where lots of new entrants enter the space. And this is reduced significantly in bear markets, where buying behavior changes. And we'll go into that in more detail shortly. Next up is exchanges. The on-chain data shows us the movement of coins to and from the big exchanges that are out there. When coins go onto an exchange, that gives us an indication they may be doing so in preparation for a sale. And when coins come off, people may be putting them into cold storage and are less likely to sell them in the short term. Our next series of charts gives us a peek into market psychology, looking at short-term holders versus long-term holders. Now, a short-term holder is somebody that's held a Bitcoin for less than 155 days. And if we look at the chart and the price correlation, what we see is that as the price rises in a bull market, we reach a state of euphoria and new entrants come in. So the number of short-term holders increases dramatically. On the other side, what we see is long-term holders growing as the price starts to drop or is near bottom. They're accumulating after the short-term holders have been shaken out. They're sometimes known as smart money. These are investors who believe in Bitcoin long-term and are able to acquire nearer the lower price points in a cycle. We can see from previous cycles that when the Bitcoin price goes on a run, it gets more attention and lots of people start thinking it's a good time to buy. As more buyers than sellers enter the market, the price rises, as does the coverage, and it creates a bull run. Once the number of short-term holders in relation to long-term holders reaches a certain ratio, it signals we may be near a top. And if enough of the long-term holders start selling, then the price starts dropping and putting pressure on the most recent entrants who bought at a high price. As soon as the pressure gets too much, the recent entrants then start selling, normally at a loss, and the bull run is over. On-chain also allows us to look at the network as a whole and see how it's being used and changing over time. Here we review the total transfer volume, which is showing us how much Bitcoin is moving across the network each day. Before October 2020, we had between $1.5 billion and $2.5 billion moving each day. However, that has grown significantly and is now between $5.5 and $7 billion per day. So on average, over the last 18 months, the network usage of Bitcoin has tripled. The other change has been the type of transactions. Alongside the increase in volume, we also see the number of transactions that are $10 million plus has grown from 10 to 40% of all transactions. This is most likely a combination of institutions, very high net worth individuals, and exchanges. Finally, a useful graph to understand is the RVT ratio. This is the realized value to transaction ratio and could be compared to a company's price to earnings or PE ratio. It gives us a view on whether the demand right now for Bitcoin justifies the current realized market cap. Now, the realized market cap takes the price each Bitcoin was last transacted for, as opposed to the market cap, which takes all coins and multiplies them by the current price of Bitcoin. And the realized market cap is then divided by the transaction volume, which is in effect telling us how much demand and utility the network currently has. Through the first 10 years of Bitcoin, we see a strong correlation between transaction volumes on chain and the price of Bitcoin. In this graph, the RVT ratio is the blue line and it's inverse. So when it's going down, this is bullish as the transaction volume or network use is going up compared to the realized market cap. And when it's going up, it's bearish. And at the peaks, it's been a good indicator of price cycle bottoms in recent times. Right, there you have it. That's my whistle-stop guide to on-chain analysis. Just a reminder for you all, crypto analysis is complicated and takes time and practice to master. But don't let that stop you getting stuck in. The more you do it, the easier it becomes to see the patterns. And the best traders have a system that they follow which reduces impulse decisions. Finally, I can't say enough, this is not an exact science. It does not guarantee profit or guarantee against losses. But it will give you the tools to make better informed decisions. And that is only a good thing. If you want to find out about other areas of crypto analysis, make sure you look out for our other films on fundamental and technical analysis.